What's up, guys? It's J-Roxxx. Welcome back to my channel. I'm here to finally do my updated Q&A, and I hope I answer everything you guys want to know. So we're going to start off with something good. So the first question is, why did you stop being vegan? And that was from It's Your Girl underscore Aaliyah. So basically, as you guys know, I was vegan for 7 years of my life, and I recently became pescatarian. And it's because I was on tour, and when I was vegan, I was eating really, really bad. I was only eating like French fries, Starbucks, nothing nutritious. So there's nothing wrong with being vegan. It just wasn't fitting into my lifestyle. And so I just wanted to switch it up, you know, do something that was a little bit easier for me. I still don't eat meat. I don't ever want to. And I might, you know, potentially be vegan again. So that is why I stopped being vegan. And I still love animals. I still think it's a great lifestyle. But as of right now, I am not participating in that. So I hope that answers your guys' question. So the second question is from SZTTS. I don't know how to say it, but they asked, any regrets that I have as an artist? So I have a lot of regrets as an artist. I'm not even going to cap. But one of my biggest ones, I guess I could say, is that I didn't make as much English music as I feel that I should have, because a lot of people kind of boxed me into the Spanish music category, which is cool, but I don't speak Spanish, so it's a little bit hard to keep up with that sometimes, and I wish that I did have more English records out for you guys. But I mean, I could still do it. That's coming soon, but that is probably one of my biggest regrets as an artist. So the third question is from Layla H. Paz. She asks, when is the next song dropping? So I don't know if you guys have seen my TikToks, but I recently dropped a snippet for a new single that I have coming out. It's called Superstars. It's my first like official rap record, and that's dropping, but I don't know when I'm gonna drop this YouTube video. I'm not even gonna lie, but maybe this month if I drop this in February, or in March. It all depends when I get the music video done, but most likely in March, and I hope to have that out for you guys ASAP. And I'm really excited because it's a full English record, and like I said, it's totally different from anything that I've ever done, so I hope you guys love it. So the next question is from BMT dot underscore Selena. She wants to know, what do you do on a daily basis? Girl, I ask myself the same thing. I have free will. A lot of people think that that's like heaven and that it's fun, and it is not, bro. It feels like torture. I feel like I'm quarantined every day, because since like a lot of people in my city kind of know me, my dad doesn't like me wandering around everywhere. And a lot of my friends and my parents, they work like all day. So it's like, I'm just by myself and stuff. And so I literally just do random errands. Like I'll be going to Target, you know, doing random stuff. If I'm not working on music, of course, but mostly like that's how I spend my free time, or I'll be in LA, recording. But yeah, I mostly live life as a normal person if I'm like not on tour or in the studio. So this next question is from, it's like supposed to be Light, but it's spelled weird. Light 1230, and they asked, would you ever be friends with your fans? So my answer to that is, I'm already friends with a lot of you guys. Like I respond to hella DMs. I talk to you guys all the time. I'm always doing like hosting Twitter spaces. I'm always going live on TikTok, Instagram. And I literally have befriended so many fans because I think it's so cool that these people just love me and support me like just for existing and shit. So yeah, I would be friends with you guys. Maybe not like the creepy ones and stuff like that, because I was doing a little bit too much, but for a majority of them, yeah. So the next question is from It's Your Mother. That's their username. And they said, is there another career that you would have had if becoming an artist never worked? Yes, most definitely. I was in college before I became an artist because I wanted to be a nutritionist, because I was like obsessed with health and stuff like that. I wish I still was. And I also wanted to be a teacher as well. That was like my dream job growing up. I don't know why, but I just want to be a teacher. Like that's it. There's a lot of things I wanted to be. I wanted to be a teacher, author, movie director. I wanted to be anything like that was creative, you know, anything dope. But yeah, my biggest dream was to be a teacher or a nutritionist. The next question is from It's Katie, not Katie. And she said, how has your life changed becoming a singer? Honestly, it's so weird because like in high school, I was like always like the weird girl and shit. And everyone thought I was just like emo and just weird. You know, they used to think I was weird, and people would talk about me and they would post stuff about me. And I was used to being like very outcasted and alienated from like my peers. And I didn't have a lot of friends. You could ask my parents, my sister. It's just so crazy because I guess you could say my career took off when I was like 17, which was straight out of high school. That's right when I graduated. graduated, and then I have all these people that love me. It came in masses, and it just feels weird because I'm not used to people loving me like that, like on a mass scale. And they just love me for like being myself, which was always what I was criticized for. So I guess that's just kind of weird, you know, but like in a good way. And like when I go out in public too, it's like people ask for my picture and I just feel normal and shit, like, you know, like I'm at a restaurant or like shopping at the mall and people just come up to me and I think it's like I don't know, it's weird, but like in a good way, you feel me? The next question is from it's.jazz42. She said, what's the hardest part about being an artist in the Chicano culture? I would definitely say the hardest part is that you get boxed in immediately. You make one song that like is for the culture and they don't want you to do nothing else. Me personally, I'm more than that because I'm an artist all around. Me being Chicano just happens to be what's in my blood, but it's not my personality, you know, that's my DNA. It's definitely not my personality, it's just the culture that I grew up in. And I would say that's like the biggest challenge for sure, because they only want you to remain as this like one-sided person when we're multidimensional. So it's very hard to like expand, but I'm gonna do it anyways. That's just one of the biggest challenges that I faced, I feel like personally. The next question is from sd.anna. I actually know her, shout out to Anna. I always respond to her DMs, I love her. She said, what are some things that people mistake or misunderstand you for? And I would say that ties in with the previous question, is that people just see me for like being Chicana, and that's all that they could see me as and nothing further. And I kind of hate that, but it's up to me to change people's perception of me by showcasing what I can really do. And I hope that my career in the future is able to prove people wrong, like their presumptions about me and stuff like that. But I don't know. The next question is from 813.samara, and she said, do you at some point feel unmotivated to do anything at all? Yes, you can ask anyone in my life that knows me. I go through like really, really, really bad, insane, depressive episodes where I just feel like no hope for anything. I feel just very unmotivated. I don't feel like myself at all. And it's really hard to pick yourself back up from like slumps like that, because nobody can get it out of you but yourself. So you just have to help yourself, you know, and it's really hard. But I would definitely say for sure, because sometimes my career doesn't go where I want it to go, or things don't do as good as I thought they were going to do, and it could be very unmotivating. But I mean, the only thing that you can do is just to be consistent, you know, consistency throughout your career and everything that you do as a person is probably like the only thing that's gonna work. The next question is again from SD Anna. She said, the pros and cons of being an artist. So I would say, let's start with the pros. So the pros is that I get to meet hella famous people. I get to perform at huge shows. I get to meet all my fans, you know, doing meet and greets, taking pictures, talking to them, changing people's lives. That's in fucking insane, obviously. You know, every time I go live when I'm bored and stuff, I just have a bunch of like mini me's that just want to talk to me. I would definitely say just all the love, obviously, and getting to do music videos, getting to go to the studio, getting to kind of, I guess, have free reign with my job, kind of, because it's not a normal job that most people have. I don't know, I mean, you get free stuff when you go places, that's cool too. And I would say some of the cons are when people wanna take pictures of me when I look ghetto. You know, I had this lady wanna take a picture of me at 7 a.m, no makeup, pajamas, but I still took it with her. But that's probably one of the things, is like when I'm kinda having an off day or something and people wanna take pictures and talk to me for a very long time. And I'm never rude to them, but sometimes in my own mind, it's kinda like hard, you know what I mean? Another con is, I mean, this goes for anybody on the internet, not just being an artist, but like the constant hate, because at the end of the day it doesn't get to me, because obviously I would have quit if it did, but it's still a lot to take for one person, you know what I mean? So you get so much hate on the internet, the last thing you want is like hardships in real life. I don't know, to be honest, I would say like those are like the only cons. Maybe feeling tired all the time from like traveling and performing, but that's not even that bad. So those are the pros and cons in my mind. The next question is from Jesus21. He said, why is it important for you to project yourself with different genres? I feel like it's important because being an artist is not just limiting yourself to one thing and doing that forever. It's like just expressing yourself. And me personally, I feel like that comes with multiple genres, because there's multiple things that you feel go through in life and all this stuff. And so to be able to portray that is, to portray so many different genres, one, is rare, and two, it's just, it broadens your creativity and it can open doors to like different audiences instead of being closed off to one type of people, you know? And also just because I feel like I can do it. Like, if I could do a rap song, then why not? If I could do a fucking mariachi song, then why not? If I could do reggaeton, pop, like, then just, like, why not? Like, what's gonna stop me? So this next question is from day444u. So I know this is a question that everybody has been wanting the answer to, and y'all are all up in my business trying to know about this and everything. And I think this is a girl. She asked, are you and Fabio dating? The answer is
no, God!
No. The next question is from I_likeboobies_. And they said, do you think you'll ever date again? And to be honest, not for a very long time, because the last and first relationship that I was ever in just left me too, like, mentally drained. Like, I cannot do that again. I just want to focus on myself and my career, and there's a lot of things that I need to get done before I start thinking about another person, and I'm just not interested unless Eminem just happens to slide up in my DMs. You already know, like, I'll break all morals for that man, but that's not gonna happen anytime soon, so that's, like, my only exception. But no, I don't think so. It's just not my priority right now. And the next question is from Andrea with 3As.479. She said, what is your Starbucks order? So I'm like, I want to have it, like, right here on the screen so y'all can screenshot it, but basically it is a grande iced matcha green tea latte made with oat milk, only 2 scoops of matcha, add 2 pumps of vanilla, add vanilla sweet cream cold foam, and that's my exact order. And I get a warmed butter croissant on the side. DTX.gret asked, if you had 3 wishes, what would you wish for? I would wish to be super skinny like Bella Hadid. I would wish for, like, one of my songs to, like, massively blow up. Like, I'm talking about, like, Little Tekka type beat. And I would wish to, like, get proposed to by Eminem. So those would be my 3 wishes. I know some of y'all are gonna think I'm selfish because you're like, oh, why not end world hunger, like, stuff like that. I don't know why. Those are the first three things that came to my mind. And then the final question that I'm gonna be answering today is from _Iliana. And she says, how are you, Jay? And don't say good. She said, I genuinely wanna know how you feel. So I know it's been a while since I posted a video, and the reason for that being is because I just felt very, very lost in my career, and I felt very lost as a person. And like I told you guys, I did recently go through a breakup, and I'm open about that because it's the truth, and that's why I had been dealing with a lot of just, you know, mental stuff, and it was really hard for me to just be myself and to be dealing with a whole music career while, like, my personal life stuff was going on, you know what I mean? And it was just really, really hard to focus, and that's why I'm scared and I don't want to get into another, like, serious relationship anytime soon, because it really took a toll on my mental health, and it just made me push the brakes on a lot of things that were important. And like I said, I completely lost my sense of self. And I don't know if you guys have probably noticed, like, I definitely became more negative, and I was surrounding myself by just the more negative stuff than positives in my life. And, you know, I stopped working out. I just stopped caring about a lot of things that meant a lot to me, because I just lost myself, and that's the truth. And I just hadn't been happy for a very, 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 very long time. Until recently, I had to check myself and had some talks with people around me that are very important to me, and had to get myself in check and everything. And, you know, just keep going, because my career is gonna walk away from me if I choose to not prioritize it anymore, if I choose to just not care. And I can't have that with everything that I've built up after all this time. It's just not worth it. So, yeah, I've been trying to get more in tune with myself, doing things that are making me happy, you know, dropping more music, working on more content for you guys. And I just want to go back to the Jay that you guys always knew, and I don't want to be all depressed and shit no more. So, with that being said, like I always say, what is real will prosper. And I love you guys so much. If you stay to the end, make sure to post about it on your story and tag me. Let me know that you watched it, what your favorite part was. Make sure to drop a comment down below, and make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. I love you guys so, so, so much with all my heart. And we're making a comeback 2023. to be vegan again, but that is why I am currently not. So I hope that answers your guys' question. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay, can I redo the last part? Okay, do I still look the same?
No.
The bloopers is probably gonna be the funniest part. I just like, yeah, when only these two show in the front. See, being a girl is so annoying, bro. If I was a guy, I would just put on a hat and be done with it. But you're asking to get blocked. Anyways, do I look fat?
No!